ATM fraud has allowed an international band of thieves to steal what might be the largest single bank heist in history. And the details are pretty interesting. So first, let's talk about how they did this, and then we'll get into the logistics of the group and their leader and all that. But so hackers obtained debit card data, eliminated withdrawal limits on the accounts, created access codes, and then sent a network of operatives fanning out to rapidly withdraw money in multiple cities. So to break that down, basically what they did is there's two banks. It's Rock Bank in the UAE and the Bank of Muscat in Oman. They were able to hack into their accounts and get information on all of these debit cards,
and
basically.
And they were prepaid debit cards.
Prepaid debit cards, exactly. Yeah. And then across the world, they sent out these operatives in different cells in different cities using any kind of swipe card, apparently. You could use...
Yeah, what they did is they copied the swipe stuff onto other cards. They made those up. And what they did with these debit cards is they removed the daily withdrawal limit
exactly.
on all of them.
So they could take out huge amounts of money.
Lots and lots of money.
Yeah. It's actually a pretty genius move. The only downside of it, and I would have told them immediately that you're all going to get caught, mm-hmm. is because they have too many accomplices.
And a lot, yeah.
Yeah, and when you have that many accomplices, fanned out all across the world, it was involved Romania, Japan, Canada, Germany, 12 other countries, mm-hmm. and they're all supposed to collect the money and then get it back to you, right? And keep a certain percentage. First of all, that's some of that money. God, right? Like, keep it
I
real.
Only took out $50.
Yeah, right. I couldn't get this thing to work.
Yeah,
you're supposed to wrap it in plastic. Yeah. That sometimes helps.
That helps. Right.
Yeah. And then there's going to be the knuckleheads, as we found out in this story, that are going to just go in there with no disguise, mm-hmm. and there's a camera, and they're going to take a picture of you, and you're going to be immediately
Or
caught.
Post pictures of them with money, the rich kids of Instagram, basically.
Right, yeah. Some of them did that. They're like, oh, this is the money I stole. Okay, because when you fan it out that much, you're going to get knuckleheads.
You get chuckleheads, yeah.
Right? And then, what are those knuckleheads going to do? They're going to turn you in.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Or they're going to kill you and take your money.
As it turns out.
Yeah, yeah, so the ringleader, Alberto UC Lajudpina, I probably butchered at least two out of three parts of that. So he ended up dying. Seven have now been arrested just in the U.S. New York cell alone. But really fast, I want to give you a perspective of how many people were involved in this. So. There were two separate attacks, one in December that was smaller, maybe it was some sort of trial run, and then the big one in February. 36,000 transactions around the globe, over 40 million stolen, 45 million stolen if you include the first attack as well. That's amazing. This is definitely going to be a George Clooney movie in the next couple of years.
Yeah.
He might be the guy who gets killed, unfortunately. but yeah, it's amazing what can be done when money is just converted into zeros and ones.
So it was smart in the execution of figuring out how to remove the caps so that they could take more money out, et cetera. Mm-hmm. And in the end, it's the largest theft, the $45 million. But remember, the banks have subsidies from the U.S. government by conservative estimates over the last 3 years of $102 billion.
And that's the most conservative.
That's the most conservative. Okay. So one is $45 million. The other one is basically $102 billion from the American taxpayer. Mm-hmm. Okay, so the largest bank robbery ever is not a bank getting robbed.
Right.
It's the banks robbing us.
Yeah.